It's important to have a holistic monitoring and reporting solution in place to track the changes that are happening in your environment. Veeam One is a tool that provides you with proactive alerting and analytical information so you can make informed business decisions. One feature of Veeam One is Business View. This allows users to identify and group machines based on business function or by machine type. By tagging and grouping machines, you can ensure machines are getting the proper protection to meet any compliance regulations. Let's hop into the lab and see how you can set this up in your environment. Before we get started with our demo, if you haven't already, be sure to click the link in the right-hand corner of this screen. This is going to take you to veeam.com so you can download a free trial and start working with Veeam One. This is Veeam One Business View. As you can see, there are already predefined categories and groups that have been configured in my environment. If I right-click on Business View Settings, I can import settings into Business View from external sources. So if you're using vCenter Server tags and System Center Virtual Machine Manager tags already, you can easily import them into Veeam One Business View. You can also import from CSV file. This is going to synchronize data with categorization from third-party software. If you don't want to import these settings, there's no need to. All you have to select is Do Not Import. You can also create exclusion rules for Business View. If there's any machines that you want to exclude from being grouped, this is where you can set that up right through this wizard. Next, let's go ahead and create a category. You're going to want to select what type of category you want to create, if it's a virtual machine, host, storage, or computer, and then let's create a name for our category. You can select the categorization method. As you can see, there are three methods that you can use. You can do single parameter, which allows you to configure dynamic categories based on a single property of an object. Multiple conditions, so you can configure static categories and create groups with multiple object properties, or grouping expression, configuring dynamic categories through expressions. Next, we're going to choose the property. There are many different virtual machine properties that you can choose from, but since we want to group our machines by operating system, I'm going to choose Guest OS. Next, you can create a new vSphere tag through Business View as well if you want to. I'm gonna click Save, and then that category is going to quickly filter in here through Business View. There it is, we can see, and now we can see our machines grouped by operating system in our environment. Now I wanna show you how to create a category based on multiple conditions. So I'm going to come in here and I'm going to create a name for my category. I'm going to choose a virtual machine as the type. And next, I'm going to choose the multiple conditions option here. So I'm going to create a group name. This one's going to be databases. And then I'm going to choose my grouping conditions. So I'm going to choose from a variety of different properties that I want to group my machines by. In this example, I'm going to go by name, I'm going to choose the operator, I'm going to choose contains, and then I'm going to specify the name of the machines that I want to include in this group. I can also add a multiple properties here. So if I want to add a multiple property in here to pick up machines, I can do that as well. You also have the ability to link these conditions together with and or rules. If you want to set a group owner for your categories, you would set this up here. This is basically going to allow a specified person within your business to only receive alarms based on those specific machines that are in that group. Next, I'm going to add another group into my category. This one is going to be called web servers. And I'm going to choose the same property types here to categorize my group, but I'm just going to change the name to pick up those different machines. You still have that option to set a group owner. And then I'm going to click Save. You can see that we have that option again to create a new vSphere tag category. And then I'm going to click Save. And we're going to see that category filtered in here shortly. Awesome. So as you can see here, I have my category and I have my two groups that have been created using Business View. Now I've shown you how to create Business View categories and groups. If you have any questions, be sure to leave a comment below.